Early. I like it.
Green machine there. What does that mean, Ed Twilford? Twifflord?
Machine.
What's up, guys? What's up, guys? Hello, hello. Guys, I put up a link before I started with a bug out trailer list of stuff that's on Amazon. It's not complete, but there's a ton of the shit that's on there. And excuse me while I have some delicious beverage.
There we go.
That's like the most annoying sound ever. That's worse than chalkboard.
Sometimes like I'll start like on purpose like eating crackers or something. Because somebody always bitches like, oh, very professional. I had to turn it off because you're eating fucking crackers. I got something for you motherfuckers. Shit's going to be different around here. Now that Rob's handing me props.
Oh, shit's about to get real.
About to get real. Edward Bentley says, that's one intimidating trailer. Well, we like to call him Johnny Five. You can call it whatever you want. Hey, James, I want to know about your plans for water and ammo storage. Yeah, I bet you do. Terry, are you a Patreon? Because, Patreons help support the channel. And, you know, if you're not, that's great. But if you are, that's better. And the Patreon people, I come a little bit more free with information with those guys. It's worth a dollar. So the bug out trailer, let's go ahead and start. And I want to answer as many of these as I can so I get to talk tonight.
Okay. Dude, it's your show. You do you.
Yeah, but you're going to answer some of these. I'm going to be like this. Like,
Look, it's going to be like 20 minutes of that, and then it's going to be 20 minutes of the same shit.
Okay. So who else has helped with this? Tell me who I forget. I got Chad, Mike, Zach, Chris, Jordan via email with the radio stuff. I haven't told anybody's last names. I didn't ask for permission.
Scott is the other one that we're missing off of there.
Sorry.
And then, I think that's it.
So all you guys that have helped via email,
and Matt,
like
Matt
Jordan.
Well.
Sorry if I haven't kept a good log, but you guys have helped via email, like Jordan, or in person, like you guys that helped out Alumni Weekend when it was 1,000 fucking degrees. You are appreciated, and I mean every broken zip tie, every. whatever you guys did or helped do or whatever.
A lot of broken battery chargers too.
Yeah, we'll get into that. So I just, all the guys that have helped, thank you. Okay, Rob's here tonight. Rob's done the lion's share of the work on it, but everybody that helped was important. Okay, so I'll read a question. You can answer as you see fit. What kind of controller setup are you using for input switching? I think I saw a touch panel on the right of the rack. And you don't have to go into super detail on these. Just
sure. I think that was Scott Wexler's question. So, yeah, we're using a...
you mean Scott Wexler that makes really badass cutting boards?
Yes. As a matter of fact, I did. that particular Scott Wexler.
Wow.
I didn't know that was one of his. That looks good. I like that.
Keep talking.
Just like plug-in-ola and all that kind of stuff. Okay, so the controller that we're using is a Crestron DMPS 3.
You don't need to go into all that.
Crestron controller. Crestron DMPS.
And so that's what you're using for input switching.
Yep, it handles all of the HDMI switching as well as...
When you explain this stuff, explain it like you're talking to me, not like you're talking to smart people.
Well, you know what an HDMI is, yeah?
All right.
The video cable?
Yeah.
Yeah. It switches that. It does all that. It's the magic blocks. It's the brain.
Anyway, you didn't have to re-fucking explain it. I knew what the fuck you meant. You don't need all the detail for these morons. Okay. To switch the trailer to generator or whatever, do you have a dedicated line or is it a switch connection?
Okay, so to switch over to the generator, we have a automatic transfer switch. So generator will engage 15 seconds later, will be on the generator power or on the shoreline. So the shoreline or the generator is what takes priority.
That's what it's called, a shoreline. I keep forgetting that. I'll answer this one. Could you do a schematic of your wiring? Yeah. No. We could. We're not. That would cost money. And I know there's somebody that said that they would pay for like a diagram. No, you won't. No, not for, like, I price things at what I would charge to fucking want to do it.
Sure.
I don't want to do it. That costs a lot more.
Yep.
So, sorry about that. How did you fix the G4 to charge each battery separately?
Okay, so we bought a handful of 200 amp battery isolation switches, and we're driving those with a relay. So when the shoreline is plugged in, the batteries get separated. When the shoreline is not plugged in, the batteries get combined, if that makes sense.
That was a great answer.
It's automagic.
That was a great one. Also, could you charge battery 2 and use battery 1 at the same time?
That's not the way that it's wired up.
So how would it work?
So you use either all 4 batteries.
Or none.
Or 1, technically. So it's either 1 or all.
Okay.
If you're using 1, you are also maintaining and do have some charge applied to that at the same time.
Okay, I think that's kind of what they were asking.
Yep.
So for me, why is it not like camo painted or something like that? I don't think you guys understand. Camo sticks out when you're transporting something. But I've got a metric shit ton of camo netting, military camo net. If I need to cover it up, I will. This whole thing of why isn't it wrapped? First off, most of the camo you see on shit is wrong. And what I mean, it's little bitty patterns on a truck, but it's a cool mossy oak or something like that. That's not camo. When you see the military camo with these huge big splotches on it, that's what camo is. It breaks up the outline of it. So taking some pattern and making it really small, a camo pattern, and putting on a big thing doesn't camouflage that thing at all. It's a fashion statement. So that's number one. And then I don't want it any kind of camouflage because I want to be able to travel with it without people looking at it like wondering what that is. On the outside of it, I really want it to look like some travel trailer, you know, some cargo trailer. Okay. Also, I'll answer this one. People are asking about, like, why don't you have a bed in it or a shower or whatever the case may be? This thing is to transport stuff. And so it's going to have, like, boxes and bags and things like that in it. When we get to the place, I've got pop-up tents and things like that. You know, we got a pop-up tent for the cook station, for the kitchen, if you will. That'll be there and things like that. But the trailer, like, it will be packed to the brim. And so I just got to figure out what's going in it. But I got more than enough to pack it to the brim. And so it's for transport. Now, when all that stuff is out, that room will be there. So we have things like this kind of goes into another thing. But I am going to install E-Track on it. And the E-Track's great for lashing stuff down. So when it's being transported, all that stuff. But also the E-Track... you can put shelves in, like from side to side. And so I might have a shelf up there and have stuff stacked on it. But when that stuff comes off, that could be a bed, or if it was lower down to the next set of tracks, it could be a table that's inside the thing or whatever the case may be. I haven't quite figured out in my head how that's going to work. And it'll probably have several generations of me figuring it out after we do a full run and, you know, over New Year's Eve and stuff like that. But that's some of my ideas on that. What's the thinking behind, and these are almost like fucking like calling you a dumbass, like, yeah. or when people say, what's the thinking behind, what they mean is, why don't you think about this like I do? So what's the thinking behind using plastic boxes and cover instead of metal boxes and covers regarding the plugs and switches?
What was on hand, and that's about it.
Okay. Does metal offer some advantage that we haven't seen? I know if you hit one with a hammer that the plastic breaks easier.
To be honest, I think that's about it. Like, I don't think that you're going to see, with where we have everything run, I don't think that you're going to see any downside to using Romex over MC. And that kind of ties into that one there as well. But
I don't even know what that is. I just put it down.
Yeah.
What's Romex?
So Romex is that it's rubber clad, and then MC is metal clad.
Okay.
It's basically in conduit or not in conduit.
Gotcha.
So with where everything is run, I don't think that it's going to be a problem. And then I think our other thing that we're going to do there is we're going to end up putting a covering over all of that wiring to encapsulate everything.
So what I find that people do, and I don't care if we're talking about building a car or a gun or whatever, they figure out what they know about. Like, I know about this part of a gun, like a gas block, or I know about this part of a car or a cargo trailer. And then they try to find something in there that they think should have been done better, and they try to ask you a question about that. I think, not all, but a lot. A lot of people have asked me about, is there going to be an awning on it? Well, probably not, but the thing is I got pop-ups, as I already said, and so those I could put a pop-up right outside the door and things like that. So and pop-ups are cheaper than awnings and easier to travel with and stuff like that, and useful for other things. Okay, so how many solar panels mounted and how, poly or microcrystalline? And let's go with that.
Okay, so there are two solar panels on the roof. I have no idea where you got
them.
They're
on the Amazon list.
They're on the Amazon list. So there's two up on the roof. One gives me 24 volts. The other one gives me 12. The 24-volt one is the one that charges the batteries. And we've got four 75-amp-hour marine-grade deep-cycle gel batteries in there. So 300 amp-hours total.
Okay. And then that question was, what kind of batteries? And
they're 12-volt marine deep cycle.
Any discussion on the decision making there would be good. So basically that decision was made before he got here. Those batteries were recommended to me by somebody that, you know, first off, I think we all agree it should be deep cycle batteries. And after that, it becomes what's your budget. And I bought those batteries were $100 a piece.
And weight.
Budget and weight, and those batteries were $100 a piece, and I thought we needed one, and we wound up with more.
you said one, you got two, and I said, hey, you got two, you may as well get four. So
and, hey, and he kept saying in the video today, like, I kept saying, hey, how about this and how about that? Is this motherfucker that was how about this and how about that? Just fucking making the record straight here.
I suppose I did make my bed there.
Yeah. are you planning to set up a repeater? There is a repeater on that rack.
Yep.
And the last question I have here, and we'll scroll back through these things.
Okay.
With the trailer awesomely powered, do you have any plans for a powered water filtering system? So here's what I have, and we'll see what you think. I don't have a powered filtering system. What I have are two of the 6-gallon Berkeys, the big Berkeys, and I do have a unassembled, got all the parts to it, 12-volt water pump system and sump to put in a creek to power water up to the Berkeys and put them in there and stuff like that. That's what I have right now. Any water filtration experts that got something they want to throw on me, I'll be glad to listen. That's all I got on that. And I also have some of the propane-powered hot water on demand for sink and shower and things like that. Some stuff I bought, I don't know if it's going to work or not, and shit like that. Like, I didn't have anywhere to go on this other than watching a few people doing conversions and what kind of worked for them. But a lot of this stuff is just like, fuck it, let's see if it works. And,
yeah, it's a big experiment at this point.
Yeah. Okay.
Here we go.
Camden Plumbing Supply logo, says John Kranz. That might be good. Greg Smith, do you address EMP or any other type of surge protection? Yes. How much weight was added to the trailer? No, I don't know, but not that much.
No more than 400 pounds.
Yeah. some of you guys are asking stupid shit. I don't give a fuck to answer that. 13th Apostle. Yeah, I've got a phone here. Oh, no, that's not a phone at all.
See, it's a carrot. That's what we did there.
Propane and propane accessories, yeah. Yeah, if you're any propane and propane accessory experts, I might need some help.
Can't kill it at your service.
Kyle says, I would make sure to get a metal ramp that folds down onto the wood ramp. Makes for rolling things easier. Okay. Jeffrey Stelling says, think we should get a grand tour next weekend. Nope. I won't be here next weekend. Are you putting a hitch bracket on the back of your trailer in case you come across something you want to tow so you can?
Couldn't do it. He was asking about tandem trailers. You couldn't do it with that one. It's not a good foot or a goose deck.
How do you ground protect the trailer against lightning strikes?
We have ground stake.
Boom! Okay. Chase Kelly, okay, thanks on that. I'm learning a ton.
Pure camel, no.
Different water options just came.
No, I don't think it's going to be an issue. There's a battery maintainer that stays there, and then the temps on the TVs, I'm not concerned about that at all.
Yeah. Drew says, how much does it cost, trailer and all? I don't know. I don't want to add it up. But I know this. I know this. Money was wasted, not him. Money has been wasted on things that, and so I don't know, but a dual axle trailer is gonna probably cost you, you can get them used typically $2,500 or so for a good dual axle trailer, somewhere in that price range. New, they probably start about $35,000 to $4,000, depending on brand and style and all that stuff. But I would recommend, if you got more than a family of four, I'd recommend a dual axle because you're going to need more shit. And I'll have grandkid number 6 here in January. That's a total of 12 people in my inner circle that I have to take care for.
Not sure the size of the tire, but they're bias ply.
Ted Jones, I never had a trailer with bunk beds in it.
Me either.
Ross says, what are y'all doing tomorrow? I got to work. Thanks for asking.
Getting on a plane.
13th possible. Are you going to insulate the walls? No. Brian Lagarde says, I do LP and natural gas. Let me know what you need. That's the thing. And I'm not being a smartass. I don't fucking know what I need. Like, you might be able to, I might have fucking shit everywhere. Yeah. And you might come here like, hey, we could just do this.
Gee, I that sounds familiar.
No, I mean, like, listen, there's shit I know about. There's shit I don't know about. And I don't fucking put on my macho shit and fucking pretend a fucking thing. Especially about electricity and fucking gas. Like, shit that blows me up, I'm fucking afraid of.
Jackson spare tire, yes to both.
Yeah. Yeah, I have spare tires and Jackson's.
Plural S.
Mm-hmm. Don't answer all the questions. Yeah. Some of them I don't want to answer.
Sure. I just can't read that fast.
Yeah. PlayStation or Xbox for the grandkids? Yes, we will. There will be a game system.
You got a place to plug that in, too.
Yep. HDMI.
See what I did there?
Bam!
Learning has occurred.
That's crazy how you did that. Just put it right in there. What size is the trailer? I said it in the first video. I measured it and all. I can't remember now. I'm sorry. I don't. I mean, I just don't have the information at my fingertips. Brian Phillips said, my dad said if you have to ask the price, you don't need it. I disagree with your father. I've heard people say that, but... on subject shells, if you install E-Track, you could use stabilizer across the body trailer. Yeah, I said that, Max, but thanks. I said those exact words. Max. He's really strong.
Maybe Max wasn't here for that.
He's really strong. He's not really smart. Brian Mark says, how come you didn't go with the tow hauler? How come I didn't go with the fucking RV? Fuck, I don't know. This is what I got. Guys, it's okay. Christopher Columbus returned to Spain, found the New World, returned to Spain. He was at a dinner party. And at the time, dinner parties, like an hors d'oeuvre around the house, there would be boiled eggs. And one of the guys said, to Columbus, they said, you know the story?
No.
He said to Christopher Columbus, he said, well, all you did was sail west. Columbus said, yeah. He said, hey, can you balance this egg on its end? Because I can. And the guy tried, and the egg kept falling over. And he goes, you do it. And Columbus picked it up, smacked the bottom of it with a spoon, and set it on its end. And the guy said, yeah, it's easy. Yeah, you can do it that way. He said, yeah, now that you know. Okay. I didn't know. Like, I don't know. Guys, you're seeing me experience this. Like, he fucking 2 hours he spent fucking working on the goddamn wiring in there because I wired a fucking box backwards. Like, I don't fucking know. Like, I don't know.
That was fun when I pressed the button and did the sparky thing.
Yeah. Sparks, not good. Electricity or gas, sparks are not good. What is the voltage and amps in the batteries and what does the panels output? That's too fucking much. I don't know. Like, we 75 amp hours per battery. There's four batteries. People keep asking about overheating. If they're overheating, so am I. But we have a vent. We have a fan. I'll have other fans.
Don't have to turn it on.
We also don't have to turn it on. Or we can just turn pieces of it on. What low range are those tires? They're the 14 ply. Thanks for asking. That's a good question. Josh Bryant says started layaway for wife. Is it worth waiting for to wear the pistol? Just take fighting pistol, Josh.
It will change your life.
So for you guys that are watching and interested in this stuff, if you're an alumnus over New Year's Eve, it's not on a weekend, the 29th, the 30th, 31st, and 1st, we're doing a bug out, camp out thing again. You're welcome to join us. Sign up on the website. It's $5. And that $5 is just to give us an exact head count. And I'll take all your $5 and I'll make you a bucket of chili one night or something like that. The RV from Stripes, the EM50. Yeah, that would be badass.
That would be badass.
He said the RV from Stripes. You can tell, he don't know how to use the fucking internet because he's like, the RV from Stripes. He had the EM50, motherfucker, the urban assault vehicle. How about doing shelves lengthy-wise so they could fall down? Why? I don't understand. Rhino liner, ? Well, it's a liner that you spray into, truck beds. It's a rubberized coating. It has different textures. Yeah, Scott Wexler, you got to be careful with electronics because they contain the thing that makes it work is called magic smoke.
Magic smoke.
And if you release the magic smoke from, say, your computer, any electronic item, it won't work anymore.
It is the worst.
13th Apostle. I don't know what we're talking about, man. Brian says, are you going to do a weekend drive with the trailer? Yeah, over alumni weekend. I don't know what you already heard. Everybody's talking magic. That's right, dog. Restroom, ? That's a place where you go and do a number one or a number two.
Or that magical number three.
Evening, James. You being on the road with what's most essential equipment in your home plan? What case? Evening, James. You being on the road, what's the most essential equipment in your getting home
plan? So what's in your get home equipment?
Stuff.
That's important.
Communication's always important. You got to know if you got a home to go back to, stuff like that.
Thanks, Robert. I appreciate the comment.
Is there a dedicated toolbox for the trailer? There's just not in there right now, but yeah, I'll have tools and all that shit. With a meter and other tools that could be used for everything inside it. Yeah. Why don't you make me up an electronics toolkit? A list on the bug out list. I mean the bug out trailer list on Amazon.
Copy.
Do you mind?
Not at all.
What? Why are you laughing? Come on, man. Well, that way I can have all the shit that you would want there should something happen.
Yep.
Because if there's the medical gear we're talking about, maybe there's another dude that's fucking.
Fair enough.
What was used for heating? I don't understand the question. Do you? What was used for heating?
I think they're asking if there's heating inside the trailer.
No.
The rack does a decent job, as long as the doors are closed.
Ross, I do not own a Humvee, nor would I ever. Does your trailer have brakes? Yes.
Yes, yes, it does. They came in handy this morning, too.
Rainy. James, what is your preferred news outlet? Fucking going outside and listening to traffic. Terry Williams says, any security besides camera? Yes. If you guys think I'm going to tell you all of my fucking security that I have, you're wrong. That's fucking inner circle shit.
John Kranz, there won't be a fluke on that list.
Looper RX, I'm glad you enjoy it. Thank you. Klein Pliers, question mark. Well, Klein is a company that makes tools.
Good tools.
Good tools. Some of them specializing with electronics, electrical stuff. Why do people do that? Why do they just say, well, noun, question mark?
I think they're trying
hamburgers, question mark.
They're trying to make the list for me.
I don't know. Oh, okay. Okay, fair enough. Are you planning on adding a fridge to the trailer? I have toyed with the idea of some stuff like that. I have not. I've not committed to it.
Pierre, because Fluke is expensive, and a Klein will do the same thing for a third of the price.
At Hubble, I already have the fire extinguishers, and they will be mounted inside. I might put one outside, but I'm worried about anything on the outside getting stolen off of it. You know, in case I have to go somewhere.
It is missing a swing.
Ross Amber says, what are your thoughts on Humvees as a bug-out vehicle? Well, first off, if you got an H1, you have a real Hummer. If you have an H2, you have a Chevy Blazer. Sorry, a Chevy Tahoe. And if you have a 3, you got a Chevy Blazer. So if you got an H1, it's probably a pretty badass vehicle. But, I mean, people ask, what about a bug-out vehicle? Like, fuck it. You know, who knows, man? I mean, if my biggest thing here is the New Madrid Fault, if that thing goes off, there won't be a fucking bridge from the Mississippi to Nashville. So a fucking Hummer's not going to do me shit. So what I'm going to tell everybody is this. If the bridges fall, drive up to the bridge, get out of your car, and leave the fucking keys in it. I got a fucking feeling everybody's going to take their fucking keys with them. So you're going to swim across the river. You left your car. You're going to swim across the fucking river, and there's going to be a shitload of cars with no fucking keys in them. You know what I'm saying? Like,
it's going to be that dumb.
Well, it's like the people when the fucking pilot landed in the Hudson. They all got up and like they were deboarding and got their fucking carry-on luggage and shit. I'm like, fucking people.
Brandon Hebert, I am not an electrician, nor do I claim to be one.
Oh, yeah, I wouldn't hire an electrician. They've too many rules and standards. Listen, if you want a Hummer or a Jeep or whatever, I don't give a shit. How bad does your gas mileage go down hauling a trailer that size? I don't fucking know. I don't look at the gas mileage meter. Yeah, Biff Benford, I've checked out van life and I've checked out that other stuff. Ross Hammer, what the fuck, man? What is up with these Humvees? How many Humvees do you own, Ross Hammer? How many? Only somebody that fucking owns Humvees would ask that. It's like the sixth goddamn question in a row. Fuck. James, are you running normal tires? No. I do not have any airless or filled. Unless they change it, there's a federal law that says you have to run pneumatic tires on the roads, that you are not allowed to run solid tires on the highways. It's a federal law, unless it's been changed the last few years.
Crackerjack 182, there are redundant charging for the batteries. They can either go via the 7-pin, via the battery maintainer, via the solar array on the roof. There's lots of different options there.
Plugged in while the truck's running.
Shoreline.
And then a shoreline generator. So there's 5 different ways that can be charged. And the batteries are backup. The batteries are not first line. Batteries are last line, right?
Yep, that's correct.
True. According to my people, the best bug out vehicles are shopping carts and bicycles. I don't disagree with that. But I got fucking 11 other people. I'm not gonna watch my goddamn grandkids starve to death. What's a good gas can to store fuel in without any fuel? If you go to my Amazon store, we've put the link up several times. If fucking Shelton walked away, somebody puts that link up, and I've got links in my Amazon store to the best fucking gas cans you can get.
Crazy Local, it's labeled that because it's there simply for GFCI.
Hey, post that link up again, please. Yeah, Drew, he is the proverbial, I got a guy. He's that guy. Scott Wexler, I am probably still going to buy that transit van. Again, I got a fucking, I got to haul 12 people around, or, you know, me and 11. Will you beef up the truck alternator? The next truck I get will have dual alternators. Other than that, I don't know what I could do to beef it up. I mean, I know you could probably buy one with more amps or whatever, but I haven't considered that. I'm looking at a new truck, Pierre, so that's what's up. Terry Williams said an inflatable boat might be handy. You guys might think he's making a joke, but I actually believe that, you know. My brother, in his vehicle, he lives pretty far from his house. He has got it's a canoe, but it's not like an inflatable. It's like semi-rigid, but it's folding. And
folding rig.
Yeah, so it's actually pretty fucking cool. Do you have any plans to alter your truck suspension for this trailer? If you load your trailer correctly, you shouldn't, as long as you don't outrun the towing capacity of the vehicle that's pulling it, as long as you load the trailer correctly, there shouldn't be much of a problem. And if anybody in here disputes that, please, if you have real knowledge, let us know.
Totally agree. I can run a 10,000 pound trailer behind my Tacoma. Maybe not legally, but it works.
Right. Right. I have the alternator in my truck that came on it. Scott says, I may have found a candidate. For what? What are we talking about?
I have no idea.
Sorry, Scott, man. Sorry, man. Has the windshield windows on your truck, is it bullet resistant? What the fuck kind of questions are these? You think I'm going to drive my family through a fucking war zone or something? People keep asking about gun ports on this thing. So I'm going to hide behind a piece of fucking aluminum foil and poke a gun out of it? That's fucking the stupidest shit ever. Oh, and they asked me if I'm going to armor it. Do you know how much an armored trailer would weigh? I mean,
fuckload.
Tens of thousands of fucking pounds. They don't fucking armor the roofs of armored trucks because their fucking suspension wouldn't handle that extra weight.
You should call the AR 500 dudes and just see what a plate that
weighs. Dude, I don't have to call him. I can Google that shit. I know what a plate weighs. So yeah. Imagine enough of the fucking... fuck. Cracker Jack, confirm what about the towing thing? Do you think it's worth to allow a techie along in bug out situations? Here's what I know. Even when I was contracting in Iraq, dudes would show up all the time. Hey, I'm looking for a job. I can fucking shoot. Yeah, everybody can shoot, dude. What else can you do? Like, huh? Like, can you cook? Can you make the fucking internet work? Can you make the generator work? Those were big.
I can do all three of those.
Those were fucking big things, man. Big. Can you fucking PM a vehicle? Those were big things, man. Everybody can fucking shoot. Everybody can shoot. Crackerjack 182 said you can exceed the towing capacity a good amount if it's loaded right.
Yeah. It's just stopping you got to worry about.
Ross, yes. My Ram is 4x4. You have run out of questions for the night. Please stop asking. I've answered more questions for you than I have for any other person.
Pierre, you can certainly PM a vehicle.
Justin, it's a double axle trailer, but I've driven heavy shit before. I feel good about it. Like armored cars. Like the gas works a little, the brakes not at all. Okay, Rick. Yes. Welcome to the show, Rick. Takahashi, if that is your real name. Sounds like a Mexican dish. I'll send you back to Mexico. Let the Mexicans eat you. No, Rick. He's a pretty good dude. Over New Year's weekend, we're doing the bug out camp out again with all the alumni. And I'm going to have it out there. And I imagine it's just going to be a list of shit that I didn't get right that give me a chance to get stuff right and make a list of stuff else I need or whatever and all that stuff.
Yeah, it still needs a shakedown. Where is your monster, by the way? I haven't seen one.
What do you mean?
Your monster. I expected there to be.
You
like
mean
seven,
this?
There, I expected there to be like 17 cans on
you
this
You mean
table.
This? All right. I have a Ford 2150. Oh, sorry about that, man. It's easier to get rid of the clap than it is to get rid of a Ford. I was just kidding, dude. I was just kidding. No, I'm not. I'm just kidding. John Kranz says, all the people in my circle are required to have multiple skills. What do you got, John Kranz? Undercoating treatment for the truck and trailer? No, I haven't. Edgar, is there anything new? Nothing new on the table. Sorry. Reed, ARC DC charging system is a great way to go. No need for dual alternators. I don't know what that means. Okay. All you guys are listening to fucking shit now. You also have to be an alumnus to fucking be invited to this shit. And through at least one contractor class. Yeah, the sips are supposed to sound annoying.
I can assure you they're more annoying in person.
Yeah. Hello, Thomas Moreland. A sane voice in this crowd. Morty Nation said, I missed something. What's with the rabbit items? What's with Google? They did. People do it to me all the time. They go, hey, what's up with, you know, the earth and gravity? You know, shit like that. I'm like, what's up with Google?
You ever seen that website, Let Me Google That For You?
Yeah, oh, yeah.
I love
Shelton
that.
Introduced that's me to my, that. I use that all thing. The time.
Oh, I love me some falafel. Pierre, can you make falafel at the alumni?
Nah, he makes like Americanized bullshit. I speak more Arabic than him. Habibi. Makul mushkila.
Have you received permission from the Crown to transmit?
Yeah. Somebody said certified welder. Like, see, I don't want certifications. I just want to do the weld. Like, certified people, like I can't use this rod. I got to have this other rod or shit like that. Oh, I need this shit welded up. Are you going to add a litter or any long-term medical trauma? Yes. Yes, I am, and there will be more videos. We have just gotten started. Thomas Moreland said, that's a generous appraisal. Biff said, can you build a welder? That's the guy I want to hang out with right there. Soundboard check. Fucking Shelton. That's right.
Oh, my goodness.
Will he be selling his services to the general public? No, but if you're an alumnus and you got a shitload of money, he will. Adam Gonzalez, you got to be an alumnus if you want to be invited to this party, man. I'm sorry, man. There's a whole bunch of people in the world, and you're either an alumnus, meaning my brother, or you are not, meaning I'm sorry. But it's not personal. There's people in line in front of you. Do-do-do. Rob, do you have an opinion on the Goal Zero? I don't know what that is.
Me either.
Okay, sorry, we don't know.
Not my area of expertise.
Sorry, we don't know. Pierre says, I guess I'll leave all the dishes I was going to make at home for Thanksgiving. Bullshit. I'm building a trailer to pull behind my Jeep for camping. Rock on, brother man.
So you don't kill your truck alternator. Yeah, dude.
So if I see you kill your truck out, multiple dead batteries to your truck on, probably kill your alternator. Yeah, I got you.
Agreed.
Got you.
Not a problem.
Sticks fan says, sir, request permission to speak. If you have a question and you ask it in a full length, like a complete question, I'd be glad to give it a run. What you need welded, I can take care of that. Yeah, fat nuts, I figure you probably can. You're going to be welding on a handrail for my porch pretty soon. Terry says that you can weld off your alternator. I've heard people say that. I've never seen anybody do that. Damn. I do not have a ham license, nor will I ever get one. Let's see what else we got here. Yeah. I did a homemade cabbage hat out of a box trailer. We did a trailer jack on every corner, long-term stays. Okay, cool.
You don't have that problem if you have bias ply tires.
Mm-hmm. So you said, what classes did Rob take? And what? How about what's next?
Next is probably going to be trifecta.
What's up, guys? Oh, shit.
Oh, the direct action dudes are rolling in.
The direct action people are here now. Go Zero Yeti, battery with built-in electronics. I don't know what the fuck that is. You guys can come up here if you want to.
And more dudes with, the more dudes with rifles, the better.
Yeah, so these guys are just coming in from the night shoot of direct action. Come on up. Come on up. Come on in. Scoot across the back. Fill in the gaps. Don't put the little guy in the middle again.
Oh, he's got a stool.
Okay. That's Lewis's fucking...
Lewis's stool. Scoot over.
Rob, did you put an HF radio in the trailer? We have all the yes. H's and all the F's and some A's and M's. All that shit. We got all that shit.
AM, FM, HF, VHF, UHF, and SATCOM.
Fuck it. Do you have a welding machine for your bug out trailer? No. Like, there's a whole bunch of shit that's not going in that bug out trailer. Like, a welding machine, not going in there. Why would I get a welding machine? These dudes told me I could weld with a fucking alternator a minute ago.
You can.
Anyway.
They're Canadian.
Somebody just posted I couldn't see it. Contractor's class, you see your team. Is that arranged before class or when you show up? Before class, Mike Brown. Lewis, get off the radio, says Pierre.
I'm team leader, Pierre.
Perfect. Perfect. Fat Nuts, yes. SUT is the first contractor class.
Pierre's supposed to be here.
Pierre is supposed to be here. Oh, well.
That's right.
You know, he's a fucking Arab, so they're built out of fucking, like, quit. Quit and hate and Allah. Is Lewis standing on Mookie's shoulders? All right, Moreland, he came in quiet. Boom, got a good one in right there. I like it. Crackerjack 182, I agree. You're better drilling and bolting shit than trying to fucking weld off a battery. Jesus, people. Me and you are going to get along, Crackerjack. You stick around. A lot of people welded with an alternator by accident. Oh, man. You get those lightweight plates yet, Lewis?
Nope, still rocking the heavy ones.
Still rocking them. Got them in there right now?
Not right now. Right
you
now.
Fucking pussy.
I mean, they're in the carrier.
Did you have them when you did the...
Oh, hell yeah.
Okay,
yeah,
yeah. All right. Just make sure you ain't being a bitch.
I got no Pierre in me. I mean, pussy.
Big Pryo says, what's stopping you from getting satellite TV for the trailer? Paying a fucking satellite bill every month for fucking something I'm not using.
That's literally it.
That's... Like, it's really like, oh, God, there's got... I got an AM radio. Why do I need fucking satellite TV?
Have they not seen the DVD collection at the team?
Yeah, I don't want to fucking use my alternator to weld anything. Guys, let's go on to the next thing. I took a motorcycle safety course. How do you care for your motorcycle in the winter? A trickle charger and Pry G in the gas.
Person asking that is from Dallas, so I don't know how bad their winters really get.
You've been called out. Now, basically, if my bike is not being ridden, it's on a trickle charger, and it'll make your battery last a year or two longer. Same with your lawnmowers and all that shit. Op center. What'd you have for lunch? What SATCOM provider carry using Iridium? Iridium is a brand. My provider is Blue Cosmo. the Iridium is the phone. I don't think Iridium actually does plans. I don't know. Maybe they do, but. Are you required to have night vision of your own for SMU? But there's no night vision in the contractor classes. If you have it, you can bring it, but it's not part of the contractor classes. Yet!
Help. It will help for the night shoot.
It won't hurt. Can the dirty half dozen back there tell us about the class? No. They're not allowed to talk. currently attempting to building a bug-out cabin out of skids and surrounding logs. Okay, rock on.
Baird, they like your jug.
Hey, listen, crowd, you can't be reading shit out. Are you going to get an 8-track for the trailer? What do you think? I was thinking about getting a 4-track, too. Why not ride your motorcycle in the winter from Chicago? I'm sure you ride your motorcycle in snow and ice. I'm sure you do. I'm sure you do. I say open a great cost bug-out trailer company. Nobody would fucking buy one.
They have free over-the-air satellite you can buy.
Okay.
Let me think about that for a minute.
All right.
It hurt my brain.
If I have to buy it.
They have free over-the-air satellite you can buy. Wait a minute, Garth, wait. That's so crazy, it just might work.
My fucking head hurts.
there's no 1911 guys in this crowd. You don't find those very often around here. Justin Angel! What's up, man? He said, I've never missed a man before. You're a damn liar. Man, it's good to hear from you. He's a judge in Middle Tennessee, so you guys should be on your best behavior.
Who's on your podcast?
So, Justin, you'll appreciate this. You know I talk about people should do jury duty.
Yeah.
So I got my jury duty questionnaire in. I filled it out the same day and mailed it in, put it on my calendar. Tomorrow's jury duty.
Yikes.
Today I called. Hey, just want to make sure you got my questionnaire in because there's going to be some times when I'm gone, blah, blah, blah. And they said, is this Jaeger? I'm like, yeah. Yeah, you missed it. I'm like, what? She said, it was 3 weeks ago. We just thought you weren't coming. And I'm like, I can come tomorrow. I got it on my calendar here. And they're like, no, let you talk to Sam, the court clerk. And so they said, how can you be here at 12? I said, that's what I sent the questionnaire back about. I'm not going to be here in November. But I want to be on the jury. They're like, okay. I'm like, thank you for not sending the police to my house.
You might could have got
They were just like, we just didn't think you were coming. And didn't say anything. Didn't
or care.
Okay. Got me out of park today.
I think they all went, hey, should we go get Jaeger? And all of them went, no.
Not a good idea.
No, let's just leave him alone. Adam Gonzalez says, I live in a mobile home. My house is a bug out trailer. I like your attitude. I like it. Do you recommend an XS standard big dot for hunting? XS standard dot for... I don't recommend an XS standard dot for fucking anything. At all. Trailer needs a name. How about... You don't get the name at Dr. Relish. Your fucking stupid ass name. He was Dr. Delish. That was his son's login. We made him get his own login. And now it's Dr. Relish.
Dr. Relish.
Like, fuck you, motherfucker. Good choice for flip-up irons. Man, there's a bunch of them out there. I like Midwest. There's a bunch of them out there. Tell the guy with the jug to put the jack down. There you go. I pick an old YZ250 in the winter. Okay. All right. Good job. What do you mean you can't imagine me on a jury? I'd be fucking awesome. I'd be like, it'd be like,
straight up nullified.
Dude, if they want to write a fucking story about me, it'd be like 11 angry men, because I wouldn't give a fuck. That's a joke. There's a short story called 12
Angry Men. Yeah. The ultimate dad joke.
Justin said, nothing ever goes to trial anymore. I get it. Good seeing you, Justin. Come hang out, man.
Yeah,
Yeah, if Justin's there, I would love to hear another podcast with him. His last one was good.
Yeah. Judge, you want another one? Let us know.
Get him and Dana in the same room. That'd be awesome.
Living where you live, do you just carry water purification and limited water in the ammo? Water gets really heavy really fast. Was it like 7 pounds a gallon? I don't have a desert problem. I mean, like, even if I were happen to be somewhere where there wasn't a creek within fucking 100 yards of me, I could just start digging and 2 feet deep, I'd probably have fucking water anywhere in the state. Brandon says, we all forgot at least one court case. Yeah, the fucking ADA is fucking pissed. No Fergie poster. Man, Fergie is my speed. Like 100%. Oh, Grant, thanks. 8.34 pounds per gallon. I think gas is like 7 pounds, but somebody's going to correct me on that in a minute, too.
No, I think you're right.
Doctor of Violence. See you in April for Fighting Pistol. Fuck yeah. He's going to find his whiskey. Well, hope you make it. Terry Wim says, is lapping your upper worth it? First off, I don't even know what that is, so no. So whatever you're reading, whatever you're doing, stop doing that shit.
Buy a training class.
Like, shoot your gun till it fucking rattles apart, then tighten all that shit back up. Cody, bug in versus bug out, what went into your decision to bug out? I didn't make a decision to bug out, but if I don't prepare to bug out, I don't have a choice. Is there a bunch of music stored on the iPod or something for the trailer? It's probably a good idea. So if anybody has I can't say that because I'll get 500 fucking iPods.
You'll get 500 iPods and every single one of them will have a Rickroll on them.
I don't know what that is.
What's Rickroll? Oh, come on. What? You never been Rickrolled?
I don't want to Rickroll.
Oh, you're going to get Rickrolled.
You're going to get Rickrolled so hard.
Is that bad?
Wexler, I need a Rickroll in the comments, please.
I think we can save it if you want.
This is not going to end.
Yeah. A free air satellite receiver are designed to receive unencrypted FTA transmissions using satellite receivers. Only one legally can receive TV signals out of satellite encryption.
Interesting. Know. I'll Google that.
Yeah, there's always somebody waiting to piss in the creek, that's for sure.
Nickelback only iPods, that's funny. That's almost worse than a Rickroll. Yeah, there it is. There's the Rickroll.
I don't know what it is.
Thanks, Scott.
I still don't know what it is.
Don't do it.
Is it like this?
I'm just getting started.
Prepper Rabbit says, since you have so many alumni, where do you bug out to? I think you guys are missing the point. This trailer is for where I don't know what to fucking do. Like, the fucking earthquake kicks off. Maybe, check this out, maybe everything else I own is fucking under my fucking house. And I got this bug out trailer where all the houses have collapsed and shit. Maybe I don't go anywhere past my front yard. And I set this shit up and use it. It's a backup plan. All any bug out shit is a backup plan.
We just need to get to Tim's sailboat. Then we'll be all safe.
You said Tim's Rocky sailboat? Theme. No. That song is called Eye of the Tiger, 13th Apostle. Now he's going to tell me no, the other instrumental. No. It's Eye of the Tiger. Fucking people. Rock on, Dallas 10 per. What does that mean, Dallas 10 per? I don't know. So it's like trying to figure out what license plates mean, you know, personalized license plates. And then you realize it's from a state. It just has weird-looking license plates, and they don't make any sense. Jason Rapport says, where all these fuckers come from? I don't know.
You missed them by about an hour.
Chris Deaton says, hey, James, can you do a 22-250 video? Yeah. Send me the gun, the ammo, and $1,000 for filming it.
I could probably do two of those three.
Well, as long as one of them is $1,000, I'll do the video.
That gets me a high five to the face, too, doesn't it?
People ask me to do videos about shit I don't want to do videos about all the time. And it's like, if you're going to pay me a grand, I'll make a fucking video. Like, if you want to see me juggling, pay me $1,000, I'll do a video fucking juggling.
I'll do whatever you want for $1,000.
No, I didn't say that. I did not fucking say that. Juggling. Don't fucking know. I did not fucking say that.
He did, though, say, send him $1,000.
Evan says, how's your daughter's hunting rifle come along? Good. We got her a ground blind. And actually, where's Sam?
Where is
Evan? Actually, I got a pointer on actually a chair that goes in the ground blind that swivels with a gun rest on it. Good tip from Sam. And we're going to get her out and get her using that stuff soon. But she actually passed her hunter education test, 90-something. She missed, like... she missed the same question Jay missed on his carry permit question. And so don't anybody here say anything. So the first person that guesses what the question was that they both missed on both tests, I'll give you a class, 2-day class, here in Camden in the summer.
Can we guess?
Okay, and go.
Loaded. That has something to do loading the guns.
That was, no, you're right.
That's the one I heard. Wexler, I saw them moving a couch into Tim's office earlier today.
So, Pro Gun Inc., better long-term MREs or day tricks? I have got a combination of from dried rice to Mountain House to MREs, power bars. Like, I've got a big combination of foods. I've got some lifeboat rations for people I fucking hate. If you soaked a lifeboat ration in 12 ounces of water, you would still need 2 more ounces of water. Dude in the orange shirt carries a 40. No, he doesn't.
Nope.
No, he doesn't.
Nope.
Unload weapon and vehicle. No.
The only way
we only got about 6 minutes.
I don't know about y'all. The only way that I'm unloading a gun in a vehicle,
not finger on trigger,
it's at a target.
Yeah. Through glass.
Through glass.
Shooting from a road.
Nope. Not shooting from a road. Your big one was. I'm gonna give you a follow up. The big one was. It's the question Jay missed. That's more telling than Heather missing it. Let's see. Not carrying a handgun. Not unloading fence.
Cleaning? Something about cleaning. Something about cleaning. You gotta shoot it. Jay definitely got that one wrong.
Should never try a gun.
Huh? You already tried. If you guys got a fucking guess you want, let me know.
How often you should clean a gun?
Not exactly it. Area, but you don't get to try again. You fucking shot your wad on that one. Not squib load. My son said lifeboat rations taste like a cinnamon flavored geography book. That's funny.
That is funny. That next one down is pretty good too.
Not see, no. Putting the mag in wrong, no. What are you looking for? Check the chamber, no. Always shoot loaded, no. First thing you do after shooting, no. Not about the safety. Not about gun cleaning kit for calibers. Brett Robinson, you're a fucking idiot. Never post here again. You don't know what the fuck you're talking about. You're just some fucking internet jackass. You never had a training fucking class in your life. You don't have any fucking practical experience. You're probably not even a fucking mediocre competitor. Shut the fuck up. Not hunting over bait. Make sure the animal's dead, no. Make sure your gun's unloaded, no. Halloween party at Teasers tomorrow night. Who's
do it? Let's go.
We
got Final X on Friday though.
But shit, you'll be home by 8 if you go to Teasers. Nope. Thanks for your vigilante law. Hopefully this summer I can take a class. Well, Andrew Peterman, we'd love to have you because you seem like a polite young man. Was it locations you can't carry in? Nope. 3-round max the gun? Nope. What constitutes a muzzleloader? Nope. What would cause it to explode? Nope. Squib? Nope. Was beyond the target? Nope. All right, we're getting close here.
It wasn't about cleaning.
I didn't say that. I said you haven't guessed it. You can't just say noun and fucking get an answer right. Alex, something about fucking art for 500. Not common malfunctions. Dude, no. You guys are all asking the same questions over and over. It's none of those. They're just trying to remember any question from the fucking thing. I'm going to fucking say it again. Jay got this question wrong. No, you guys are asking the same questions over and over and over. Throwing ammo in a garbage can. That's funny. I got in trouble for that in Hungary.
Really?
Yeah, they didn't like that at all.
I saw my very first ammunition amnesty can at an airport security.
Was it in America?
It was.
Yeah, I'm talking about we threw some fucking like rounds that were fucking like primer strike. They didn't go off into a fucking dumpster. Like a fucking handful of them. They're like, people could get these and they could have them. I'm like, oh, yeah, okay. I forgot. This is a police state. They go, it's not a police state. I'm like, who has guns here? And he said, just the police and military. I said, so it's a police and military state. Fucking jackasses. Rindorseg. Okay, all right. No, not loaded when children are present. I never even heard that one before. All right. Pierre Joseph Camel. You're supposed to clean a gun every time you use it.
No.
Is that a question?
That's a question on the test. When should you clean a gun? The answer, every time it is used. Wow. You'd have missed that one, too.
Yeah.
Jay and Heather both missed that one. So, yeah. Pierre, as bad as I hate to say it. See, I didn't say it. Don't sell guns to midgets. That should be on the test. That should be on the test for sure. You got come on, keep your finger off the trigger. Jay wouldn't know that. Come on, man.
He is that guy.
Pierre said, I'll take a high five. You're going to have to fucking take it, Arab. Stinking bastard.
His last name's Camel?
Oh, yeah. That's not just a funny nickname. No, his fucking last name's Camel. He says it's like, no, it's Camille. No, the fuck it is. It's fucking Camel is what it is. Oh, man. All right. That's it, man. Anything else, Rob?
No.
Thanks to Rob and, again, all the guys that helped with that. Thanks to these guys for basically just breathing hot air in the back of our necks. You guys want to say anything? Anybody got a message, a shout-out or something? Somebody you want to yell at?
Come train.
Keep breathing.
Very motivational. This is like 9 weeks in a row for these guys. They're fucking tired. But we appreciate you guys watching. James Jagger and the rest of the crew for Tapped Response, reminding you that your responsibility to be ready for the fight never ends.